West Virginia CDL Hazmat Practice Exam.
Question 1. The power unit of a placarded vehicle must have a fire extinguisher with an all rating of BC or more.
5. 10. 15.
Answer.
10.
Question 2. Animals and human food stuff should not be loaded in the same vehicle with
poisons, explosives, flammable gases.
Answer.
Poisons.
Question 3. You find an overheated tire during an en route inspection. If you are hauling hazardous materials, you must
cool the tire, then check it every 2 hours. Remove the tire and place it a safe distance from the vehicle. Wait at least 2 hours before continuing your trip.
Answer.
Remove the tire and place it a safe distance from the vehicle.
Question 4. Only one of these shipping paper descriptions for a hazardous material is in the right order. Which one is it?
Corrosive material, hydrochloric acid, UN 1789. Hydrogen bromide, non-flammable gas, UN 1048. Hexane, UN 1208, flammable liquid.
Answer.
Hydrogen bromide, non-flammable gas, UN 1048.
Question 5. Who is responsible for safely transporting a hazardous material shipment without delay and keeping the shipping papers in the right place?
The shipper. The carrier. The driver.
Answer.
The driver.
Question 6. You do not have a hazardous materials endorsement on your commercial driver's license. When can you legally haul hazardous material?
Only if it is a non-placarded material. Only when the shipment does not cross the state lines. Only when the load is placarded.
Answer.
Only if it is a non-placarded material.
Question 7. You are behind the wheel of a truck carrying a shipment of hazardous material. The shipping papers must be in a pouch on the driver's door or in
a box under the driver's seat, the truck's glove compartment, clear view within your reach.
Answer.
Clear view within your reach.
Question 8. Who is responsible for packaging, labeling, and preparing the hazardous material shipping papers for a common carrier?
Driver. Carrier. Shipper.
Answer.
Shipper.
Question 9. Carriers must give each driver who transports Class A or B explosive
a copy of FMCSR Part 397, an extra fire bottle, the consignee's phone number.
Answer.
A copy of FMCSR Part 397.
Question 10. When hauling hazardous materials, you must stop your vehicle and check any dual tires at least once every. Whichever is less.
3 hours or 150 miles. 1 hour or 50 miles. 2 hours or 100 miles.
Answer.
2 hours or 100 miles.
Question 11. When fueling a placarded vehicle, someone must always be
at the emergency power shutoff for the pump, at the nozzle, controlling the fuel flow, within 10 feet of the pump with a fire extinguisher.
Answer.
At the nozzle, controlling the fuel flow.
Question 12. The basic description of a hazardous material includes the hazard class, the ID number, and the proper shipping name. Which one must appear first on the shipping paper?
The identification number. The proper shipping name. The hazard class.
Answer.
The proper shipping name.
Question 13. You are going to be hauling hazardous materials over a route you do not know well. When should you check the route and get the permits needed for this trip?
While you are still on a part of the route that you know. Within 24 hours of the finish of the trip. Before starting the trip.
Answer.
Before starting the trip.
Question 14. Animals and human food stuff should not be loaded in the same vehicle with
flammable gases, poisons, explosives.
Answer.
Poisons.
Question 15. You should stop before crossing a railroad grade if your vehicle is carrying of chlorine.
100 gallons. Any amount. 110 gallons.
Answer.
Any amount.
Question 16. A vehicle placarded for hazardous materials must have placards on sides.
4. 2. 3.
Answer.
4.
Question 17. When there is hazardous materials emergency, you should
keep people away and warn them of danger. Prevent smoking and keep open flames away. Do both of the above.
Answer.
Do both of the above.
Question 18. When transporting chlorine in cargo tanks, you must have
an emergency kit for controlling leaks in fittings on the dome cover plate. An approved gas mask. Both of the above.
Answer.
Both of the above.
Question 19. To stop for railroad tracks, you should stop feet before the nearest track.
10 to 35, 15 to 50, 5 to 20.
Answer.
15 to 50.
Question 20. A truck carrying explosives has crashed with another vehicle. You should not pull them apart until
the explosives have been placed at least 200 feet away from the vehicles and occupied buildings. The shipper's loading foreman is present. At least 30 minutes have passed.
Answer.
The explosives have been placed at least 200 feet away from the vehicles and occupied buildings.
Question 21. A properly prepared uniform hazardous waste manifest
is the same as any other shipping paper. Must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste. Is required only if there is a loss of cargo during transport.
Answer.
Must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste.
Question 22. The transport index of a radioactive material
tells the degree of control needed during transportation. Is another way of writing the weight of the package. Is something that only the shipper needs to worry about.
Answer.
Tells the degree of control needed during transportation.
Question 23. When hauling hazardous materials, you must stop your vehicle and check any dual tires at least once every, whichever is less,
3 hours or 150 miles, 2 hours or 100 miles, 1 hour or 50 miles.
Answer.
2 hours or 100 miles.
Question 24. Class A explosives must not be transported in a combination vehicle if the vehicle includes
a placarded cargo tank, a 200-inch wheelbase trailer, two or more trailers.
Answer.
A placarded cargo tank.
Question 25. Carriers must give each driver who transports Class A or B explosive
an extra fire bottle, a copy of FMCSR Part 397, the consignee's phone number.
Answer.
A copy of FMCSR Part 397.
Question 26. Animals and human food stuff should not be loaded in the same vehicle with
explosives, poisons, flammable gases.
Answer.
Poisons.
Question 27. You do not have a hazardous materials endorsement on your commercial driver's license. When can you legally haul hazardous material?
Only if it is a non-placarded material. Only when the load is placarded. Only when the shipment does not cross the state lines.
Answer.
Only if it is a non-placarded material.
Question 28. You have loaded a hazardous material into a cargo tank. What must you do before you move the vehicle?
Call Chemtrak by phone and tell them where you are going. Close all manholes and valves. Be sure they are free of leaks. Have the loading observers sign the shipping papers.
Answer.
Close all manholes and valves. Be sure they are free of leaks.
Question 29. If you are in an accident involving hazardous materials, you should
tell only the emergency response team about the hazard. Keep all people far away and upwind of the accident. Prevent a panic by acting like nothing is wrong.
Answer.
Keep all people far away and upwind of the accident.
Question 30. You have a vehicle with Ultrax to hold cylinders or compressed gas. You may load such cylinders only if they are
less than half of the load. Loaded upright if lying down flat and braced. Bundled loosely together with steel strapping.
Answer.
Loaded upright if lying down flat and braced.
Question 31. Class A explosives must not be transported in a combination vehicle if the vehicle includes
a placarded cargo tank, two or more trailers, a 200-inch wheelbase trailer.
Answer.
A placarded cargo tank.
Question 32. The intent of hazardous materials regulations is to ensure safety, to contain the material, and
to communicate the risk, to allow state enforcement, to tax shippers correctly.
Answer.
To communicate the risk.
Question 33. Which of the following must drivers have in their possession while transporting Class A or B explosives?
The written route plan. The carrier's insurance policy. Both of the above.
Answer.
The written route plan.
Question 34. A vehicle placarded for hazardous materials must have placards on sides
2, 4, 3.
Answer.
4.
Question 35. No one may smoke within 25 feet of any vehicle that contains explosives, oxidizers, or
flammable materials, compressed gases, poisons.
Answer.
Flammable materials.
Question 36. To find out if a shipment includes hazardous materials, you should
look at the shipping papers. Open and inspect every package and container. Check for a fence around the loading dock.
Answer.
Look at the shipping papers.
Question 37. Who is responsible for packaging, labeling, and preparing the hazardous material shipping papers for a common carrier?
Carrier. Shipper. Driver.
Answer.
Shipper.
Question 38. You are transporting hazardous materials. When you are not behind the wheel, the shipping papers must be on the driver's seat or
on the dashboard in clear view, in the pouch on the driver's door, with you.
Answer.
In the pouch on the driver's door.
Question 39. The intent of hazardous materials regulations is to ensure safety, to contain the material, and
to allow state enforcement to tax shippers correctly, to communicate the risk.
Answer.
To communicate the risk.
Question 40. You may not park a vehicle carrying hazardous materials within feet of an open fire.
200. 100. 300.
Answer.
300.
Question 41. When fueling a placarded vehicle, someone must always be
at the emergency power shutoff for the pump, within 10 feet of the pump with a fire extinguisher, at the nozzle, controlling the fuel flow.
Answer.
At the nozzle, controlling the fuel flow.
Question 42. A railroad crossing is ahead of you and you are handling hazardous material. When you stop for the crossing, you can stop as far away as feet from the nearest rail.
50. 25. 75.
Answer.
50.
Question 43. With most hazardous materials, you may park within 5 feet of the road briefly, if your work requires it. The materials that are the exception and do not allow parking this close to the road are
explosives A and B, corrosives and oxidizers, acids and poisons.
Answer.
Explosives A and B.
Question 44. Who is responsible for checking to be sure the shipper correctly named, labeled, and marked a hazardous materials shipment?
Carrier. Manufacturer. Shipper.
Answer.
Carrier.
Question 45. You are going to be hauling hazardous materials over a route you do not know well. When should you check the route and get the permits needed for this trip?
Within 24 hours of the finish of the trip. Before starting the trip. While you are still on a part of the route that you know.
Answer.
Before starting the trip.
Question 46. You find an overheated tire during an en route inspection. If you are hauling hazardous materials, you must
wait at least 2 hours before continuing your trip. Remove the tire and place it a safe distance from the vehicle. Cool the tire. Then check it every 2 hours.
Answer.
Remove the tire and place it a safe distance from the vehicle.
Question 47. Class A explosives must not be transported in a combination vehicle if the vehicle includes
A placarded cargo tank. Two or more trailers. A 200-inch wheelbase trailer.
Answer.
A placarded cargo tank.
Question 48. Which signals may be used to warn of a stopped vehicle that contains explosives?
Signal fires. Reflective triangles. Flares or fuses.
Answer.
Reflective triangles.
Question 49. Only one of these shipping paper descriptions for a hazardous material is in the right order. Which one is it?
Corrosive material, hydrochloric acid, UN 1789. Hexane, UN 1208, flammable liquid. Hydrogen bromide, non-flammable gas, UN 1048.
Answer.
Hydrogen bromide, non-flammable gas, UN 1048.
Question 50. The basic description of a hazardous material includes the hazard class, the ID number, and the proper shipping name. Which one must appear first on the shipping paper?
The hazard class. The identification number. The proper shipping name.
Answer.
The proper shipping name.
Question 51. If hazardous materials is spilling from your vehicle, do not move your vehicle.
In an upwind direction. Any more than 500 feet. Any more than safety requires.
Answer.
Any more than safety requires.
Question 52. You should stop before crossing a railroad grade if your vehicle is carrying of chlorine.
110 gallons. 100 gallons. Any amount.
Answer.
Any amount.
Question 53. Who is responsible for checking to be sure the shipper correctly named, labeled, and marked a hazardous materials shipment?
Manufacturer. Shipper. Carrier.
Answer.
Carrier.
Question 54. The power unit of a placarded vehicle must have a fire extinguisher with the all rating of BC or more.
5. 10. 15.
Answer.
10.
Question 55. You find an overheated tire during an en route inspection. If you are hauling hazardous materials, you must
wait at least 2 hours before continuing your trip. Cool the tire, then check it every 2 hours. Remove the tire and place it a safe distance from the vehicle.
Answer.
Remove the tire and place it a safe distance from the vehicle.
Question 56. You have loaded a hazardous material into a cargo tank. What must you do before you move the vehicle?
Close all manholes and valves. Be sure they are free of leaks. Have the loading observers sign the shipping papers. Call Chemtrak by phone and tell them where you are going.
Answer.
Close all manholes and valves. Be sure they are free of leaks.
Question 57. There are two lists that drivers, shippers, and carriers use to find out if a material is a regulated product. One of these lists is the
Shipper's List of Transportable Quantities, List of Hazardous Substances and Reportable Quantities, EPA Dangerous Materials Table.
Answer.
List of Hazardous Substances and Reportable Quantities.
Question 58. A truck carrying explosives has crashed with another vehicle. You should not pull them apart until
the shipper's loading foreman is present. The explosives have been placed at least 200 feet away from the vehicles and occupied buildings. At least 30 minutes have passed.
Answer.
The explosives have been placed at least 200 feet away from the vehicles and occupied buildings.
Question 59. You should stop before crossing a railroad grade if your vehicle is carrying of chlorine.
110 gallons. Any amount. 100 gallons.
Answer.
Any amount.
Question 60. The total transport index of all radioactive material packages in a single vehicle must not exceed
10, 50, 100.
Answer.
50.
Question 61. When transporting chlorine in cargo tanks, you must have
an approved gas mask, an emergency kit for controlling leaks in fittings on the dome cover plate, both of the above.
Answer.
Both of the above.
Question 62. Animals and human food stuff should not be loaded in the same vehicle with
flammable gases, explosives, poisons.
Answer.
Poisons.
Question 63. You have loaded a hazardous material into a cargo tank. What must you do before you move the vehicle?
Have the loading observers sign the shipping papers. Close all manholes and valves. Be sure they are free of leaks. Call Chemtrak by phone and tell them where you are going.
Answer.
Close all manholes and valves. Be sure they are free of leaks.
Question 64. Who is responsible for finding out what permits or special routes you will need to haul hazardous materials?
The shipper. The driver. The carrier.
Answer.
The driver.
Question 65. No one may smoke within 25 feet of any vehicle that contains explosives, oxidizers, or
poisons, compressed gases, Flammable materials.
Answer.
Flammable materials.
Question 66. A properly prepared uniform hazardous waste manifest
is the same as any other shipping paper. Must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste. Is required only if there is a loss of cargo during transport.
Answer.
Must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste.
Question 67. An X in the column of a shipping paper entry means.
This is an exception to the hazardous materials regulations. The entry is for a hazardous material. The material is not a hazardous material.
Answer.
The entry is for a hazardous material.
Question 68. A hazard class name or ID number may not be used to describe a
non-hazardous material. Reportable quantity of a hazardous substance. Hazardous waste.
Answer.
Non-hazardous material.
Question 69. Who is responsible for checking to be sure the shipper correctly named, labeled, and marked a hazardous materials shipment?
Carrier. Shipper. Manufacturer.
Answer.
Carrier.
Question 70. To stop for railroad tracks, you should stop feet before the nearest track.
5 to 20. 10 to 35. 15 to 50.
Answer.
15 to 50.
Question 71. A vehicle contains 500 pounds each of explosive A and B. You must have
blasting agents, blackguards, dangerous blackguards, explosives, the blackguards.
Answer.
Explosives, the blackguards.
Question 72. The total transport index of all radioactive material packages in a single vehicle must not exceed
50, 100, 10.
Answer.
50.
Question 73. If there is an RQ before or after the item description on the shipping paper, it means the
material has an insurance value of over $1,000. Material is in a package containing no other materials. Carrier must report any spill of this material.
Answer.
Carrier must report any spill of this material.
Question 74. If the word forbidden appears in the hazard class column of an entry in the hazardous materials table,
a common carrier must never transport the material. The carrier may not open the package or container. A shipment of that material must never be larger than the RQ.
Answer.
A common carrier must never transport the material.
Question 75. A properly prepared uniform hazardous waste manifest
must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste. Is the same as any other shipping paper. Is required only if there is a loss of cargo during transport.
Answer.
Must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste.
Question 76. When hauling hazardous materials, you must stop your vehicle and check any dual tires at least once every, whichever is less,
1 hour or 50 miles, 2 hours or 100 miles, 3 hours or 150 miles.
Answer.
2 hours or 100 miles.
Question 77. The basic description of a hazardous material includes the hazard class, the ID number, and the proper shipping name. Which one must appear first on the shipping paper?
The identification number. The hazard class. The proper shipping name.
Answer.
The proper shipping name.
Question 78. You are behind the wheel of a truck carrying a shipment of hazardous material. The shipping papers must be in a pouch on the driver's door or in
the truck's glove compartment. Clear view within your reach. A box under the driver's seat.
Answer.
Clear view within your reach.
Question 79. When transporting chlorine in cargo tanks, you must have
an emergency kit for controlling leaks in fittings on the dome cover plate, an approved gas mask, both of the above.
Answer.
Both of the above.
Question 80. An X in the column of a shipping paper entry means
the entry is for a hazardous material. The material is not a hazardous material. This is an exception to the hazardous materials regulations.
Answer.
The entry is for a hazardous material.
Question 81. There are two lists that drivers, shippers, and carriers use to find out if a material is a regulated product. One of these lists is the
Shipper's List of Transportable Quantities, EPA Dangerous Materials Table, List of Hazardous Substances and Reportable Quantities.
Answer.
List of Hazardous Substances and Reportable Quantities.
Question 82. Which signals may be used to warn of a stopped vehicle that contains explosives?
Reflective triangles. Signal fires. Flares or fuses.
Answer.
Reflective triangles.
Question 83. If you are in an accident involving hazardous materials, you should
tell only the emergency response team about the hazard. Keep all people far away and upwind of the accident. Prevent a panic by acting like nothing is wrong.
Answer.
Keep all people far away and upwind of the accident.
Question 84. Only one of these shipping paper descriptions for a hazardous material is in the right order. Which one is it?
Hexane, UN 1208, flammable liquid. Hydrogen bromide, non-flammable gas, UN 1048. Corrosive material, hydrochloric acid, UN 1789.
Answer.
Hydrogen bromide, non-flammable gas, UN 1048.
Question 85. If hazardous materials is spilling from your vehicle, do not move your vehicle.
Any more than 500 feet. Any more than safety requires. In an upwind direction.
Answer.
Any more than safety requires.
Question 86. A driver who transports radioactive materials and has to follow a certain route must have had special training by the carrier within the last years.
2, 3, 4.
Answer.
2.
Question 87. Class A explosives must not be transported in a combination vehicle if the vehicle includes
a 200-inch wheelbase trailer, two or more trailers, a placarded cargo tank.
Answer.
A placarded cargo tank.
Question 88. When there is hazardous materials emergency, you should
keep people away and warn them of danger. Prevent smoking and keep open flames away. Do both of the above.
Answer.
Do both of the above.
Question 89. You are going to be hauling hazardous materials over a route you do not know well. When should you check the route and get the permits needed for this trip?
Before starting the trip. While you are still on a part of the route that you know. Within 24 hours of the finish of the trip.
Answer.
Before starting the trip.
Question 90. A railroad crossing is ahead of you and you are handling hazardous material. When you stop for the crossing, you can stop as far away as feet from the nearest trail.
75. 50. 25.
Answer.
50.
Question 91. If you are in an accident involving hazardous materials, you should
keep all people far away and upwind of the accident. Tell only the emergency response team about the hazard. Prevent a panic by acting like nothing is wrong.
Answer.
Keep all people far away and upwind of the accident.
Question 92. A properly prepared uniform hazardous waste manifest
is required only if there is a loss of cargo during transport. Is the same as any other shipping paper. must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste.
Answer.
Must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste.
Question 93. Animals and human food stuff should not be loaded in the same vehicle with
flammable gases, explosives, poisons.
Answer.
Poisons.
Question 94. Who is responsible for safely transporting a hazardous material shipment without delay and keeping the shipping papers in the right place?
The carrier. The driver. The shipper.
Answer.
The driver.
Question 95. Class A explosives must not be transported in a combination vehicle if the vehicle includes
a placarded cargo tank, a 200-inch wheelbase trailer, two or more trailers.
Answer.
A placarded cargo tank.
Question 96. No one may smoke within 25 feet of any vehicle that contains explosives, oxidizers, or
compressed gases, poisons, flammable materials.
Answer.
Flammable materials.
Question 97. You do not have a hazardous materials endorsement on your commercial driver's license. When can you legally haul hazardous material?
Only when the shipment does not cross the state lines. Only if it is a non-placarded material. Only when the load is placarded.
Answer.
Only if it is a non-placarded material.
Question 98. If you are in an accident involving hazardous materials, you should
keep all people far away and upwind of the accident. Prevent a panic by acting like nothing is wrong. Tell only the emergency response team about the hazard.
Answer.
Keep all people far away and upwind of the accident.
Question 99. When hauling hazardous materials, you must stop your vehicle and check any dual tires at least once every, whichever is less,
3 hours or 150 miles. 1 hour or 50 miles. 2 hours or 100 miles.
Answer.
2 hours or 100 miles.
Question 100. A properly prepared uniform hazardous waste manifest
is required only if there is a loss of cargo during transport. Is the same as any other shipping paper. Must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste.
Answer.
Must be signed and carried by anyone transporting a hazardous waste.
Question 101. You are going to be hauling hazardous materials over a route you do not know well. When should you check the route and get the permits needed for this trip?
While you are still on a part of the route that you know. Within 24 hours of the finish of the trip. before starting the trip?
Answer.
Before starting the trip.
Question 102. A railroad crossing is ahead of you and you are handling hazardous material. When you stop for the crossing, you can stop as far away as feet from the nearest rail.
75 25 50
Answer.
50
Question 103. The total transport index of all radioactive material packages in a single vehicle must not exceed
50 10 100
Answer.
50
Question 104. Who is responsible for checking to be sure the shipper correctly named, labeled, and marked a hazardous materials shipment?
Shipper. Manufacturer. Carrier.
Answer.
Carrier.
Question 105. With most hazardous materials, you may park within 5 feet of the road briefly, if your work requires it. The materials that are the exception and do not allow parking this close to the road are
explosives A and B, acids and poisons, corrosives and oxidizers.
Answer.
Explosives A and B.
Question 106. You are behind the wheel of a truck carrying a shipment of hazardous material. The shipping papers must be in a pouch on the driver's door or in
the truck's glove compartment, a box under the driver's seat, clear view within your reach.
Answer.
Clear view within your reach.
Question 107. When transporting chlorine in cargo tanks, you must have
an emergency kit for controlling leaks in fittings on the dome cover plate, an approved gas mask, both of the above.
Answer.
Both of the above.
Question 108. If there is an RQ before or after the item description on the shipping paper, it means the
carrier must report any spill of this material. Material has an insurance value of over $1,000. Material is in a package containing no other materials.
Answer.
Carrier must report any spill of this material.
Question 109. When there is hazardous materials emergency, you should
keep people away and warn them of danger. Prevent smoking and keep open flames away. Do both of the above.
Answer.
Do both of the above.
Question 110. Who is responsible for packaging, labeling, and preparing the hazardous material shipping papers for a common carrier?
Carrier, driver, shipper.
Answer.
Shipper.
Question 111. You may not park a vehicle carrying hazardous materials within feet of an open fire.
300. 200. 100.
Answer.
300.
Question 112. When handling packages of explosive, you must
never use hooks or other metal tools. Keep bystanders 100 feet away. Double wrap wet boxes in plastic to prevent staining.
Answer.
Never use hooks or other metal tools.
Question 113. A vehicle contains 500 pounds each of explosive A and B. You must have
blasting agents, blackguards, dangerous blackguards, explosives, the blackguards.
Answer.
Explosives, the blackguards.
Question 114. The basic description of a hazardous material includes the hazard class, the ID number, and the proper shipping name. Which one must appear first on the shipping paper?
The proper shipping name. The hazard class. The identification number.
Answer.
The proper shipping name.
Question 115. The intent of hazardous materials regulations is to ensure safety, to contain the material, and
to allow state enforcement, to communicate the risk, to tax shippers correctly.
Answer.
To communicate the risk.
Question 116. Who is responsible for finding out what permits or special routes you will need to haul hazardous materials?
The carrier. The driver. The shipper.
Answer.
The driver.
Question 117. No one may smoke within 25 feet of any vehicle that contains explosives, oxidizers, or
flammable materials, compressed gases, poisons.
Answer.
Flammable materials.
Question 118. Only one of these shipping paper descriptions for a hazardous material is in the right order. Which one is it?
Hexane, UN 1208, flammable liquid. Corrosive material, hydrochloric acid, UN 1789. Hydrogen bromide, non-flammable gas, UN 1048.
Answer.
Hydrogen bromide, non-flammable gas, UN 1048.
Question 119. The total transport index of all radioactive material packages in a single vehicle must not exceed
50, 10, 100.
Answer.
50.
Question 120. A truck carrying explosives has crashed with another vehicle. You should not pull them apart until
The explosives have been placed at least 200 feet away from the vehicles and occupied buildings. The shipper's loading foreman is present. At least 30 minutes have passed.
Answer.
The explosives have been placed at least 200 feet away from the vehicles and occupied buildings.
Question 121. A driver who transports radioactive materials and has to follow a certain route must have had special training by the carrier within the last years.
4. 2. 3.
Answer.
2.
Question 122. You are transporting hazardous materials. When you are not behind the wheel, the shipping papers must be on the driver's seat or
in the pouch on the driver's door. With you. On the dashboard in clear view.
Answer.
In the pouch on the driver's door.
Question 123. You should stop before crossing a railroad grade if your vehicle is carrying of chlorine.
100 gallons. Any amount. 110 gallons.
Answer.
Any amount.
Question 124. A vehicle placarded for hazardous materials must have placards on sides.
3. 4. 2.
Answer.
4.
Question 125. When transporting chlorine in cargo tanks, you must have
an approved gas mask, an emergency kit for controlling leaks in fittings on the dome cover plate. Both of the above.
Answer.
Both of the above.
Question 126. Whenever your vehicle is placarded, do not drive near open fires unless you
can safely pass the fire without stopping, are equipped with fire sprinklers, have LTL of a non-flammable materials.
Answer.
Can safely pass the fire without stopping.
Question 127. If there is an RQ before or after the item description on the shipping paper, it means the
carrier must report any spill of this material. Material is in a package containing no other materials. Material has an insurance value of over $1,000.
Answer.
Carrier must report any spill of this material.
Question 128. The total transport index of all radioactive material packages in a single vehicle must not exceed
100, 50, 10.
Answer.
50.
Question 129. The power unit of a placarded vehicle must have a fire extinguisher with the all rating of BC or more.
15. 5. 10.
Answer.
10.
Question 130. Class A explosives must not be transported in a combination vehicle if the vehicle includes
a placarded cargo tank, two or more trailers, a 200-inch wheelbase trailer.
Answer.
A placarded cargo tank.
Question 131. A vehicle placarded for hazardous materials must have placards on sides.
3, 2, 4.
Answer.
4.
Question 132. Which of the following must drivers have in their possession while transporting Class A or B explosives?
The written route plan, the carrier's insurance policy, both of the above.
Answer.
The written route plan.
Question 133. No one may smoke within 25 feet of any vehicle that contains explosives, oxidizers, or
flammable materials, poisons, compressed gases.
Answer.
Flammable materials.
Question 134. You are transporting hazardous materials. When you are not behind the wheel, the shipping papers must be on the driver's seat or
with you, on the dashboard in clear view, in the pouch on the driver's door.
Answer.
In the pouch on the driver's door.
Question 135. You find an overheated tire during an en route inspection. If you are hauling hazardous materials, you must
wait at least 2 hours before continuing your trip. Cool the tire, then check it every 2 hours. Remove the tire and place it a safe distance from the vehicle.
Answer.
Remove the tire and place it a safe distance from the vehicle.
Question 136. A vehicle contains 500 pounds each of explosive A and B. You must have
explosives, the placards, dangerous placards, blasting agents placards.
Answer.
Explosives, the placards.
Question 137. When transporting chlorine in cargo tanks, you must have
an emergency kit for controlling leaks in fittings on the dome cover plate, an approved gas mask, both of the above.
Answer.
Both of the above.
Question 138. Animals and human food stuff should not be loaded in the same vehicle with
explosives, poisons, flammable gases.
Answer.
Poisons.
Question 139. Who is responsible for finding out what permits or special routes you will need to haul hazardous materials?
The shipper. The carrier. The driver.
Answer.
The driver.
Question 140. When fueling a placarded vehicle, someone must always be
at the nozzle, controlling the fuel flow. Within 10 feet of the pump with a fire extinguisher. At the emergency power shutoff for the pump.
Answer.
At the nozzle, controlling the fuel flow.
Question 141. You are going to be hauling hazardous materials over a route you do not know well. When should you check the route and get the permits needed for this trip?
Within 24 hours of the finish of the trip. While you are still on a part of the route that you know. Before starting the trip.
Answer.
Before starting the trip.
Question 142. A vehicle placarded for hazardous materials must have placards on. Sides.
4. 2. 3.
Answer.
4.
Question 143. The intent of hazardous materials regulations is to ensure safety, to contain the material, and
to communicate the risk, to allow state enforcement, to tax shippers correctly.
Answer.
To communicate the risk.
Question 144. Class A explosives must not be transported in a combination vehicle if the vehicle includes
a 200-inch wheelbase trailer, a placarded cargo tank, two or more trailers.
Answer.
A placarded cargo tank.
Question 145. When hauling hazardous materials, you must stop your vehicle and check any dual tires at least once every, whichever is less,
1 hour or 50 miles, 2 hours or 100 miles, 3 hours or 150 miles.
Answer.
2 hours or 100 miles. Thank you for watching the video and wish you will get your driver license soon.